レディース・エンド・ジェントルメン、スタート !Your engines!
Now that was an enthusiastic driver. Start your engines.
He's away by a length. Darren Lung is going to have to be really, really brave as he comes up on the outside line down towards Paddock, but he's going to lose a place. Balfe goes through. That is not at all what Darren Lung needed. A great start by Cottingham, and there's drama. Loggy has gone around. Kevin Sayes got caught up in it. John Ferguson avoids, and there are others in the gravel. McLarens are off. Mustangs are off. Mayhem breaks out at turn one. Cars scatter, but I reckon that they've all, bar Loggy, kept going. That's on the racetrack.
Oh, and look at the gravel being thrown out of the back of the...
Dangerous to those behind.
Yeah, and that is a significantly large bit of bodywork. It'll probably fly off and almost on into the windscreen. Now, they've got to do something. That bodywork has got to be removed.
Won't resume. They've reached their cut-off point for time anyway. Harry Jones just going over to make sure that... Three Carrera Cup champions involved there. Oh. And Harry's had to step into the middle of the two of them to separate them. This is extraordinary stuff. And Liam Talbot, just in the background, came onto the scene at a pretty high rate of knots and had absolutely nowhere to go.
You can see David Wall struggling to get out. He's like, he's a tall guy anyway, but he was struggling to get out. And that car has had some big hits.
Now, Shandoff's got out. Oh, wow! Colombini, no! Colombini's spun, he's been collected by the 44. I can't believe that just happened.
Going here at the moment.
Now, oh, Golding, there's going to be a massive shunt. That was unbelievable. He spun that car around and Scott Bye had nowhere to go.
And here's the reason why. So there was some wild stuff going on in the background. That's Waters. Here we go with James. He's given the tyres a big belting there and rotated out the other side. I saw him go down the order. You spotted all this going on, but Pye is a victim in the process in the Hino entry.
Right now.
There. And that's pretty significant damage on car number 20. So he's grabbed a gear, rotated it, but at the same time... And I wonder how that'll be viewed. Here we are, on board now with Jones. And we've been talking up the possibility of a podium for him. Big contact. Remember, he was in stripe on the Sunday here in the fast chicane last year, James Golding. And this is the view for Scott Pye.
Motorsport coffee over his visor. I've never come across Motorsport coffee before. That's a great shot.
That's an angle I've not seen before.
Yeah, fantastic, isn't it? You can see the effort and energies and stresses being put through the suspension components. But Motorsport coffee, Rob's sponsor. Doing that at the moment. The other person that they should sponsor is Albert Costa.
That's very true. You're right.
And Sean Tong doing a very good job in that race, as there the podium shows the podium showing the podium showing the podium showing the podium. So
the Mercedes, Darrell Young responded. They get around his boa. Not everybody gets around his boa.
Kevin Say gets tapped around, and the road is just about blocked, isn't it? So Kevin Say needs to try and wriggle out of there.
His boa is on the wide line on the outside. He can be compromised there.
That is a stopped car. That is the number 69 of Max Restrepo. He gets going again and into the gravel. Please don't tell me you beached it. Oh, my word. He spun himself around. to try and get going. And that has the Monaco Motorsport. He spun all by himself. In the middle of a pack, he's turned in a little bit too much, spun all by himself. He's trying to spin turn himself around.
Porsche. Oh no, it's gone wrong at the Melco hairpin. I was just about to say the Porsche threading its way through the Melco hairpin. It's so easy to get it wrong, to just not get the right line, to just be too tight on the inside, and it throws you over to the barrier. I don't think he'd even touch the barrier. It's just wrong. But it's now found reverse gear, can get going. So that was just a little bit of a throttle block on at the Melco hairpin. And now the question is for everyone else to get going again.
Yeah.
And they're not, unfortunately.
No, Lin Kang stole the Lamborghini. He actually was reversed into, wasn't he, by
December? Oh, hang on. This is someone we need to watch. Yeah. And he did that this morning as well.
Well, in Ginetta Juniors, he had 16.
Making sure the car was okay to be recovered. You're going to see.
He just spins, just lots of it in the spray. Yeah. And that was coming past us, wasn't it? Just opposite the pits, opposite the team. The pit lane is emptying now.
And there you can see the...
That is a very badly damaged Audi. It was sideways, it hit the wall, and he tried to turn away from the next wall, but he just couldn't. It speared it across the road at huge speed. That is a big accident, and Macau has bitten again.
Into Lisboa, having to keep that neat, tidy, tight line into Lisboa. They all want to be third, and that's not going to work, and it hasn't.
Andre Couto is off, Jack Young is off with nowhere absolute best in the first sector, who stands on the brakes and goes almost too deep into the corner. He scrabbles round Lisboa as Sam Achan turns through in third. It is still there for Adrian Chung in the lead, as toe-to-toe goes Carsten Tang there with Mo Kwoksuna. There's more contact, two more cars eliminated. That was Kevin Astra dive-bombing Earl Bamber. So they might be representing Porsche, but no love lost. And then there was contact. That takes the rear diffuser off Aston's car. And Christopher Hauser says, thank you very much. Clearly allowing Rob to join the gang.
He's doing exactly what he needs to do. And how close can Rob Huff get to the back of the Lincoln Co? This is fascinating. What's happened? The bonnet's come up on Rob Huff's car. He can't see. He can't see a thing. The bonnet has come up on Rob Huff's car.
The car's out of the way, so the... race director Rui Marquez calls for it, and wow, in a rather undignified but rapid fashion.
さすがのお二人ですね。 ね、会見やっています。
で
も本当に喜びの三番ファイト。
I would lose a lot of time. Uh-huh. Did you both stop under the safety car?
Well, yes. Yeah, I stopped again. Yeah. So my times were like 5 laps longer than yours.
Yeah. 期待しちゃいますよ。
はい。大丈夫ですよ。
うん。
はい。まあ最終戦なんで。
はい。
気楽に見ましょう。
いやなんかね、いろんなドラマがまたぐっと詰まってそうな感じがいたします。果たしてフェルスタッペンの F1 史上3人目の快挙となる4年連続ポール2ウィンを見ることはできるのかどうか、そしてもちろんその他の表彰台争いというのその中に、さあそしてレースリーダーとしての角田の姿をしっかりと、ここは国際映像とともに、ちょうど日没の時間を迎えました。日没の中で日出ずる国の勇気、角田が行きます。フランツ・トストさんが見つめています。
結構ではプレッシャーかかりますよね。
これはまた最高のシーンにはなっていますが、
have a conversation. Have you ever seen the like of it? Have you ever seen the like of it? What an entrance. Jules, what an entrance. I mean, you can get out of your boat now. This is a serious weekend. You're having far too much fun.
Yeah, we have good fun with Fabian, Maxi. That's a key factor, and also with Tusi. So, well, we have a time to have a bit of fun while the quali was interrupted. So,
onto the podium in reverse order, starting with third place.
I try to forget the night that you left. It's all so unreal with you gone. I can dream once again where the love never ends. Cause you're right here when I think of When I think